Let's take a quick look at what's been said about the cruise berthing facility. The government claims that without a berthing facility, cruise tourism will decline over time. The fact is, cruise tourism has increased steadily by 27% between 2009 and 2018. In January 2019, the Department of Tourism reported the highest number of cruise passengers to visit Grand Cayman in recorded history, and all without a cruise berthing facility.
The government claims new design will have less impact on the environment. The fact is, government has failed to present any design at all, only an artist rendering which provides no data in terms of size, required dredging, or how much concrete will be poured into the harbor.
The government claims the marine life and coral in Georgetown Harbor is already dead. There is nothing worth saving. The fact is, far from it. The reefs surrounding the harbor are vibrant and teeming with marine life. Eden Rock and Devil's Grotto are rated as two of the best shore dives in the world.
The government claims the cruise berthing facility won't cost us a penny. It will be paid for by the cruise passenger who use it, not by our people or our government.
The fact is, you will be paying.
Because government is going to give the consortium development team, led by Royal Caribbean and Carnival, a portion of the cruise revenue that is currently being banked by government.
What's more, we will be repaying them $450
million. $450
million.
$250 million more
than what the facility even costs.
The government claims coral relocation is part of our plan and has been hugely successful across the globe.
The fact is, the coral relocation program for the development of the Falmouth cruise ship terminal in Jamaica in August 2009 is potentially the largest coral relocation project known to date. In 8 months, a team of 93 people relocated over 147,000 organisms. By 2012, 50% of the relocated coral had already died.
The government claims more jobs for Caymanians?
The fact is, to date, the government has failed to produce a list of jobs,
qualifications, or salaries for the claimed jobs.
Which Caymanians will fill these jobs, and how will the project affect your livelihood?
The government claims berthing facilities will give passengers more time on shore. The fact is, in the beginning, the original cruise berthing facility that we were being sold was to accommodate mega ships that are passing us daily.
Then it switched to bringing 4 ships in a day and spreading the load out instead of 2 1 day and 7 the next.
Now cargo is being added to the mix.
So what is it that the government is really trying to sell us without any type of proper invoice?
It's your vote, your future.
So make a decision based on fact.
You deserve the whole truth.